Hi, my name is Noel Blaine, and this is my life. I was born on September 26, 1975, in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. My parents had lived there for about 3 years prior to my birth, and then about a year after that, my brother was born. About a year after that, my entire family moved down to Vancouver, where we stayed for another 2 or 3 years. And a short while after that, we moved to Surrey, into our first home, which is actually just a couple blocks away from here. And I can, that home right there is some of the earliest memories that I have. I suppose I may have been about 10 or 12 years old at the time when we first started living there. I think we only lived there for maybe 3 or 4 years, although it may have been seemed like a much longer time since time tends to go slower when you're a young kid. It was while I was living in this small house that I attended my first school, at a place called AHP Matthew, which of course is the same school you guys saw at the on the Easter blog. Although I do recall attending a different elementary school for a while, but offhand I can't recall its name. I do know where it was, but it's not there anymore. I think it must have been torn down. Although I will say that most of my memories of school do definitely start with HP Matthew. I do believe that I was still taking classes at HP Matthew when my parents decided to move into a slightly bigger home that was just about 2 blocks away from where we first started living. It was a fairly tragic day for us because the earliest memories that my brother and I had were all in that house, and therefore it felt extremely sad for us to move away from our friends that were in the neighborhood, but realistically our friends were only 2 blocks away, and therefore we really didn't have any reason to be sad, but to us it seemed that we were moving very far away. I can't quite remember how old I was when my parents decided to move into the bigger house. I suppose I may have been about 13 or 14 years old, and I think we only stayed there for maybe about 3 or 4 years before deciding to move into a condominium in the Newton area of Surrey. Again, I'm not exactly too sure about time frames, although I'm pretty sure that we lived there for maybe only about 2 years, because I do recall being about 19 years old and still living in that place, but I think it was probably within that year that I was 19 years old that we moved out into the rancher. And the rancher is where my parents currently live, and I probably only lived there for about 2 or 3 years, or maybe about 2 years, because I had gotten my first job when I turned 19 years old, and that's actually it's my first and only job that I ever got. I'm still working at that job, and my parents are still living in that house where they've been living for about maybe 14 years now. I think it was probably like a year after that I'd finally moved out of my parents' place into a shared accommodation with a 40-year-old German guy. I think I probably only stayed there for maybe like a year and a half before he had acquired himself a mail-ordered bride and requested that I humbly leave him so that his mail-ordered bride could move in with him. It was to my much greater fortune that I had a co-worker at my job that had a basement available. I decided to take her up on her offer, and that would be one of the first times that I lived by myself, and I would be living there for about 6 more years prior to moving into the place that I'm in right now. This place here is one of my first places that I've actually owned, and may very well be the last place that I'll own unless something major happens. I have been living here for about 4.5 years as of this month, and I'll be renewing my mortgage on this place this December. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is my life in a nutshell. If you want to get the rest of the story, you'd have to watch the video, all the videos that I posted within the last 2 years or so, as well as read all my text blogs that I posted on my MSN page, on my DeviantArt page, as well as I think a LiveJournal page that I posted very long time ago. I bought the camera probably about 2 years prior to starting up my YouTube account. I originally didn't have any idea what I was going to use the camera for or what I was going to use the video videoing for. I just knew when I saw the camera that was one of the cameras that I really wanted to get because it did have the video recording ability. A short while after that, I discovered that my Windows XP came with a video editing program, and I was really excited to be able to use it because I was able to take all the videos that were on my camera and import it into this program and make a really cool little video out of it. I do have some of my particularly old videos somewhere around here. I'd probably have to do some digging in order to find it, but I do have I did have a teensy bit of experience in video editing prior to making videos on YouTube. This right here is one of my first introductions to the concept of video blogging. This is a parody flash animation that was posted on somethingawful.com, and it really opened my eyes to the idea of video blogging because I quite literally had no idea about it before. And sure enough, I did find vloggers. After sorting through many different videos of many people vlogging, I ultimately arrived at this video here. After being greatly inspired by the many vloggers that I saw on YouTube, I decided to take a crack at making a vlog for myself. Given the portability of my camera, I felt it might be a really good idea to try and take the camera to other places to vlog, and would ultimately inspire me to go out and do my adventure blogging. Although I wouldn't exactly say that my first attempt at adventure blogging was a huge success after breaking my camera on the grouse grind, but I was not discouraged. After spending about $100 to get the camera repaired, I came back and continued to post videos. I originally had the idea of using my video blogging as a supplement to my text blogging, but unfortunately I wasn't able to embed my videos into my text blogs, and therefore I wasn't able to bring the two mediums together into a single blog. I ultimately decided just to stick with the video blogging since it was something that I was starting to really enjoy, but I also had a lot more friends within the YouTube community itself, and I was getting a lot more viewers and comments on my videos than I was with my text blogging anyways. I think one of the biggest differences between text blogging and video blogging is the empathetic connection that the video watcher can make with the video maker. The video watcher can make an empathetic connection with the video maker, not through what the video maker says, but rather how the video maker expresses it by various means, such as making different expressions, speaking in a different tone of voice, and of course, different types of body language that he can make on camera. And it is through video blogging that I hope all of you can have a better understanding of who I am and perhaps what I am. And ladies and gentlemen, I present to you my 100th video shoutouts.
Job. The man in the silk suit hurries by as he catches the just the way it is. Some things will never change. That's just the way it is. Ah, but don't you believe that? Said, hey, little boy, you can't go where the others go. You don't look like they do. Said, hey, old man, how can you stand to think that way? And did you really think about it before you made the rules? He said, sure. That's just the way it is.